In iiQWorks.Sim, you can configure workspaces and change settings of the brake test in the home, devices tree of the robot. If you click on the workspaces in the device tree, an overview of all workspaces will appear in a property window on the right. First, you can enable that workspaces will synchronize during a running simulation, meaning that if you change their properties with KRL code while the simulation is running, the workspaces will be adapted accordingly. Their settings will also be resetted once you reset the simulation. There are two different kinds of workspaces, Cartesian workspaces and axis-specific workspaces. You can start configuring them after selecting a workspace on the left side in the devices tree. I will select the workspace one. You can see the component properties opening up on the right side. With the XYZ and ABC values, you can change the origin of the Cartesian workspace. While entering values, you will see the blue circle of the PNP manipulation selection move along. Additionally, you can change the name of the workspace. I will call it my first workspace. Then we can change the mode of the workspace, that is set to off by default. You can select between different modes. On the one hand, the inside selection means that the violation will be set if the TCP or the flange of the robot is located inside of the workspace. In return, the outside mode will trigger the violation if the TCP or the flange of the robot is located outside of the workspace. The selections in and outside with stop means that a stop will be initiated if the TCP or the flange or the wrist root point of the robot is located inside or outside of the workspace accordingly. If you only want to consider the position of the tool center point, you can select the TCP inside or outside, with or without stop. In addition to that, you can select an output signal that will be set in the case of one of the events. I will change it from false to 150. Next, we can change the size of the Cartesian workspace by defining the distances of two edge points to the origin. You can now type in values, like minus 100 and plus 200. You will see how the Cartesian workspace is visualized. If you activate the move manipulation mode, you will see the frame of the origin of the workspace. You could also drag and drop it with the coordinate system in the 3D environment. There is also an easy option to pick an object from the 3D world and draw a workspace around it. A good way to demonstrate this is to add a block from the ECAD to the simulation, but you could take any other object. You can place it in the 3D world and turn it to your liking. Then click on the robot and navigate back to the devices, Cartesian workspaces. Select another workspace and rename it, for example, to block. Now click on the button pick from 3D and click on the block. Thereby the origin and the size of the workspace will be directly overwritten by the values of the block. In the workspace overview, you will now see how the names of the Cartesian workspaces changed, and, if configured, also the output signal numbers. The other type of workspace, the axis-specific workspaces, can also be configured. You can change the name, the mode, as well as the output signal, for example, to 200. Then you can change the axis limits of every single axis to a minimum and maximum. For example, from minus 90 to plus 90 for axis 1 or minus 180 to plus 90 in axis 2 and minus 90 to plus 120 in axis 3. You can go on for every single axis depending on your robot and cell. Again, in the overview, you will see the change of the name and the output signal number. In the configuration of iiQWorks OS2, the option to force the brake test allows you to check the functionality of the brakes on the robot's axis on a real robot. This test ensures that the brakes apply sufficient braking torque and helps detect any impairments such as wear, overheating, fouling, or damage. You can also select different axes for the brake test to ensure each axis is functioning correctly. It is important to perform this test as part of the functional test of the safety functions to maintain proper safety and functionality of the robot's braking system. Ensure that the brake test configuration is confirmed by the safety maintenance technician to avoid robot stoppage due to inconsistent configuration. For further information, training and certification regarding safety, you should visit the KUKA College. Disabling the brake test for specific axes might be necessary in certain situations, such as when axes are simulated, configured as couplable, or grouped together into a coupling group. In this case, I just want to simulate my robot in iiQWorks.Sim, so I will deactivate the force brake test.
We appreciate you watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button on the KUKA channel for updates and new videos. For hands-on trainings and courses, head over to the KUKA College. Keep exploring and learning with us.
Make making automation easier.